Moses. Yes, God? I want you to say to the house of Jacob and tell the people of Israel, you yourselves have seen what I did to the Egyptians and how I bore you on eagle's wings and brought you to myself. Therefore, if you indeed obey my voice and keep my covenant, you shall be my treasured possession among all people. For all earth is mine, priests and a holy nation. These are the words that you shall speak to the people of Israel. All that the Lord has spoken, we will do. They said, all that the Lord has spoken, we will do. I will come to you in a thick cloud, that the people may hear me when I speak with you, and you may also believe you forever. Go to the people and consecrate them today and tomorrow, and let them wash their garments and be ready for the third day. For on the third day, the Lord will come down on Mount Sinai in sight of all the people. And you shall set limits for the people all around you, saying, take care not to go up into the mountain or touch the edge of it. Whoever touches the edge of the mountain shall be put to death. No hand shall touch him, but he shall be stoned or shot. Whether beast or man, he shall not live. And when they hear a trumpet sound, a long blast, they may come up on the mountain. This must be the signal to leave camp. Stay right beside me. Don't go beyond the boundaries that Moses set for us. Moses says if we even touch the mountain, we will die. I am the Lord your God. You must not worship other gods. You must not make any idols. You must not use the Lord's name in vain. Remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy. Respect your father and mother. You must not murder. You must not cheat on your husband or wife. You must not steal, you must not lie, and you must not be jealous of other people's possessions. When is Moses coming back? I know, right? He's been up there for days. Maybe he left us, or maybe he's dead. If he doesn't come back, then what will we do without him? Let's have Aaron make us a golden statue to worship. Yeah, we should have a god that we can see. We want a god that we can see! Yeah! Give me all your gold and bring it to me. Listen, Moses. It sounds like war in the camp. No, it's not war. I hear singing. How dare you cheat on God! You promised to worship only God! Already you are worshiping a statue of a calf! What will Moses do to us?
Holy crow, what are we doing now? What's gone into us? Why?
Aaron, who made this idol? It's not my fault. The people gave me their gold. I just threw it into the fire, and out came this golden calf. I didn't worship it or anything. They did. Then threw it back into the fiery hell that it came from. Now all of you, drink the water. It's awful! I think I'm gonna be sick. Well, that's what you get for immediately breaking one of the Ten Commandments. They are a stubborn, rebellious people. Leave me alone so I may destroy them, Moses. Lord, please forgive them. You promised Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob to bless their descendants. I know they don't deserve it, but if you do destroy them, then all the other nations will think that you're a god who can't fulfill your promises. All right.